do we have the enemy?
Yeah.
Okay. She might need some if she's feeling in pain.
no.
What? Give me a little towel
and I put on her, she's a little bit shaky.
There is an issue with her back legs. She has, she's been windswept, so sitting in the uterus, a little cramped, and her fetlocks on her back legs, completely both two off to a side. So we're gonna call the vet to see what we can do. She might need splinting, not exactly sure yet. So right now it's just to get her nurse so that she can get the colostrum she needs. But I don't know how long it's going to take for her to learn to walk.
Sorry for waking you up. I just sent you a picture. This filly, when we have her hinds are lax, isn't it? Right, or flourish, but it's only, she doesn't seem to have tendons at all on her hind end to stand up. I mean, that's. Yeah.
Yes, yeah, those are the horns, yes. Yes. Nope, they're fine. She can't stand on her hinds at all. And she's trying, but there's just no... Yeah, we're holding her up with a little towel wrapped around her barrel, trying to get her to eat and move around, but... Just born. 30 minutes. Yeah, I don't know what to do in this case. I don't know if there's anything that can be done. So small. Back. Oh yeah, no, they're
lift up her. Yeah, so when you pull it back, there's some tension there, but they just are really loose. They even go sideways and they twist to the side almost. I'm looking at it right now and they are. It looks like she's broken her leg. She's starting to breathe rapidly, and I don't know what to do about. Normal hawks seem to be normal. It's just right where they can, right where the pastern stops, and it just like doesn't even almost twist to the left. You know, how the heck would you describe it? So I don't know if you would wrap them. I mean, that's like it's yeah. Yeah, I know.
Can we somehow give her something to be less stressed or something?
Yeah, she's... Right. And she's kind of freaking out now, so she's starting to breathe more. And I'll milk the... Well, she's got a suck reflex, but at this point she seems to be working more on balancing than feeding. Get some milk from the mare and start to feed the foal. started on that, and then we'll just pick her up and hold her up occasionally, and just whenever you are able to finally get out here, and we'll work on whatever we can do to fix it. All right. Thank you.
Hmm?
It's, yeah, whatever. All right. I'll see you whenever you get here.
All right. Thanks.
She gets colostrum.
It's the only thing that's going to work is rehab.
We're going to have to wrap her and stuff. Wrapping and then movement and hoping that the tendon firms up. Correctly. I don't know how to describe that. It just. Oh, man.
Is to milk the mare, give the filly some colostrum, be out here to help her move. Then the vet will show up sometime today. And we'll probably be casting her legs. There. Poor baby. She's still breathing a bit hard.
I think she'll stand still for this, but if not, I'll.
Thank you.
ride.
Thank you. sort of balance.
It's just very.
So this wrapping might actually make it work.
The legs are going in a C shape instead of straight down. The upper limb is going that direction, the lower limb is going that direction. So the tendons are very lax, but she's got a lot of spirit. She's already talking to her mama.
Minutes, I guess, to tell the rest to come down, but we've got a good 12 cc's of colostrum here. Got some copper oak now for a bit more here. Just regular dosing syringe that I bought. Normally it's for medication, but it works great for little minis and Cassian too, and it has this nice rounded tip so that you won't cause any damage. And angled to make it easier to get in their mouth. Until her milk really comes down, it's not going to do us. It's going to be a long night.
Yep, there's no sleep tonight. Dancer had one minorly windswept leg. She has four, so the front ones are really lax, but they're not as they're not.
Hinds are major.
Yeah, the front ones are lax, so they kind of bow out a little bit. But but her back limbs are majorly windswept. So it's going to take some veterinary care to get her.
Nate takes pictures. I can't describe it. It's so lax that she's walking, not just on her pasterns, but it also is so. That's normal, you know. And there it's like, I can't do it because my wrist can't twist that way, but it's turned almost on its side. And like, so it's doing like 45 degree turn out and up dorsally.
Right. She's almost walking on the fetlock. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh man, that just looks painful.
Looks like she wants more milk,
though. Say that I am extremely surprised that she's actually able to stand up on her own at all.
Life finds a way, surprisingly.
It doesn't give up. Okay. Hey, girls. When the vet gets here, obviously I need to get his permission for his audio or video. It's the state of, well, two reasons. I like my vet. I want to keep him happy. Mm-hmm. The other one is state of Washington, there's a law that you cannot record someone audio or video without their permission. An all-party state, so everyone involved has to know. But I really am concerned more about keeping my vet happy. So there's a chance that either the audio or the audio and video on here will be turned off when the vet shows up, depending on what he wants.
She's trying to nurse on her own, so that's good.
Nice shoes.
One less thing.
Be able to hold her. Yeah.
Just kind of steady her.
Well, I can't describe. It's like a rolled. What's one of those horrible, horrible ankle?
Hey, why don't you just reduce the amount of horribles?
Well, no, I want to describe like an injury of a basketball player or something. It looks kind of like that, like a rolled ankle. It's really weird. Anyway. Have to wrap it, and then also the problem with wrapping is it doesn't tighten up the ligament, so
well,
this is like this horrible.
You're stuck between standing and
right, yeah, standing up and tightening up the ligament, so it's gonna be this really crappy fine line. I'm gonna have to walk.
Resting on the right side.
Oh. Man. Wow, she's standing on it. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I figured she would.
That is.
Whew. She was trying to before, but she'll easily flop she's over.
Standing on her pastern.
Dancer for a little bit.
Come on, get out. Come on.
it looks painful, but since it's a newborn, everything is really, there's nothing super solid anyway, so there's not really a...
Very rubbery.
Yeah, there's no reason to be painful like it would be if an adult were like that. So that's always a plus.
Yeah.
Jeez. You, sir, back up.
Swept's caused by like a very low activity foal that just sort of rests in the.
Go anywhere.
Yeah.
Put it down in the way.
Maybe it's from degrading quality semen from Shotet. Because he, same dad. But this is like, we have never run into this. Legs aren't supposed to bend that way.
Not meant to bend like that. Look, I know she's not in pain, but it hurts to look at these pictures.
I know, you're just looking at the bottom of the leg. I'm looking at the hocks. Those are bad too.
Like that?
Yes, but that's quintessential windswept. And he was saying, oh, it's not very big, though, and being a mini makes it harder. Yeah, that, yeah. When she, when I said, her legs kind of bent wrong when she was first out.
She was first getting out?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, she's standing. Hallelujah.
Just don't touch her.
Don't move, and you'll be okay.
Answer complaint.
Might have to switch you out for somebody.
Yeah.
I don't know who to switch
go
on
get a
with.
Go get a suntan. Why'd you eat pink skin?
Because that's the color of the skin under white, I guess.
You did?
You know, normal. Yeah.
Did he have white under his eyes?
Yeah, all under those eyes there. Because he's got that little bit of white.
Oh.
So he's got underneath.
On the other eye, too?
Yeah.
Didn't
he's
know
just had pink eyes. I don't know why, but yeah, you can see right here where it's white and then black. So if you just had, so if you didn't have eyes, you'd see white spots there.
Oh my gosh.
Of course, the white spots would probably be the least of his concern that he didn't have eyes. And her back, once you're back,